for the Black Stars of Ghana as Ghana gets ready to support them for AFCON 2022. Mr. Speaker, historically, Ghana has won the African Cup of Nations 4 times and have been runner-up 5 times into 2010, 2015, 1992. And Mr. Speaker, one of the saddest moments was 1978, I'm told, because at that time, I was not as old as you. I was not young, I was too young even to appreciate what the Black Stars would do. But Mr. Speaker, I've had to say this because the Minister for Youth and Sports, whilst commending you, you have a challenge. And the challenge is to seek to revolutionize football once again in Ghana to make it an attractive activity and vocation for many young people. Indeed, Mr. Speaker, today is a very, very profitable venture and undertaking if you are successful in it. And Mr. Speaker, to assure the minister that sometimes it is our body language and the way we communicate that sends the wrong ends up dividing the country against what ordinarily have always united us as a country. And you can trust soccer and football, Mr. Speaker. When it comes to it, just as we're with, playing with South Africa, the whole country were yearning for nothing but victory. And that Ghana is able to make it to the last 10 to be able to participate in Qatar 2022. So kudos for that. But you know the problem. Mr. Speaker, a team, the political leadership, the president and you and us will provide it. But your technical bench is not good and strong enough. And you must work on the technical bench. And the use of old Black Stars players, don't appreciate it, Mr. Speaker. There are many experienced Black Stars players who want to play a role in supporting your technical bench to be successful. Regardless of where they come from or who they are, seek to engage them to be able to support your technical bench. And Mr. Speaker, he knows what I'm talking about. There's been instances where they need to make critical changes. Even the supporting public will know that, no, you have to change your format. But we get disappointed when he fails to do it. And then we have to be sad when we get defeated. Mr. Speaker, apart from AFCON, we have to prepare the Black Stars for Qatar. It is a must-go journey for the Black Stars. And I want to assure my colleague, the Honorable Mustafa, Member of Parliament, that the country will stand very, very united with the Black Stars to make Ghana proud. Mr. Speaker, secondly, he's raised a very significant issue. Thankfully, the Honorable Minister for Communications is here. She may hear us, but she has to work with other ministers, particularly the Minister for Trade and Industry. And Mr. Speaker, let me paraphrase from the minister's statement where he says that His Excellency President Nana Addo Dankwa invited Corporate Ghana to a breakfast meeting in order to raise about $25 million to support the Black Stars by way of funding. Mr. Speaker, truth is, government alone cannot adequately fund the Black Stars. The worst of it is when you need money and you have to wait for an Honorable Minister of Finance whose response to any demand is no, there's no money, there's no budget, it's not available. At that time, the match is only 24, 48 hours away. When the players don't hear that you are carrying bonuses along, and that you are carrying your empty bag with the promise that when they win and you get to Accra, you pay them bonuses. Not be helpful, Mr. Speaker. But Mr. Speaker, I'm coming back that I wholeheartedly support, and indeed is my position, that Corporate Ghana must finance soccer and football. And I think that a bill in that direction, corporate social responsibility bill, must emanate from the Minister for Trade and Industry, working in tandem with the Minister for Communication, so that corporate entities, I know the Honorable Arnaud Dompré has come on the floor of Parliament as a specialist on statements to raise the bar on corporate social responsibility and what we should direct it for. And I do agree with him that the corporate world must finance football, soccer, sports generally, but it will come with what you call tax rebates for them, for that particular service to the Republic of Ghana. But Mr. Speaker, in Ghana, we all enjoy corporate entities doing funeral donations and wedding donations. That is none of their business. They must focus on the real things, and the real things is for them to be able to support football. But Mr. Speaker, again, Minister, you have our support, but juvenile football is at its lowest ebb of development, not you. Successive ministers, successive administrations, both political, we have failed juveniles in this country, Mr. Speaker. And truth be told, it has nothing to do with MPP or NDC. Juvenile football in the last two decades, even academies, those who have endeavored to set up soccer academies, cannot finance them. Yet, the talents can only emanate from those juveniles with potential to develop them into becoming professional, valuable soccer players. Mr. Speaker, whilst commending him, in March, I had the joy of my life when the minister walked to my office with one of the players who is now a shining example in the Black Stars, Abdel Fattah Issahaku, who plays for my team. I do football and soccer as an additional vocation. And minister walked in when he won the best under 20 satellite player total overall in Africa. Mr. Speaker, what is significant is that since his invitation to the Black Stars, his value has gone up. I'm now negotiating very well with those other teams that are interested in him.
Also, can I guess
it? Mr. Speaker,
you two, your value has gone up, hasn't it?
Mr. Speaker, I'll share the spoils of it when the deal is finally sealed. I'm only waiting for the boy to be 18 years and I can have a formal contractual relationship. But Mr. Speaker, fair to him, just the invitation to be a member of the Black Stars, his value have soared. But brilliant, gifted player. So we owe it to support you to succeed. Then, Mr. Speaker, finally, as I end, Division 1 and Premier League. Mr. Speaker, my colleague, the Minister for Employment, he beat my team 2 weeks ago in the Brown Halfway area, Honorable Bafuewa. He has two of those clubs at Division 1 level. Mr. Speaker, to finance a football match, just 1 weekend, we go borrowing because nothing comes from the Ghana Football Association and nothing comes from anywhere. So how are you seeking to make football attractive? Mr. Speaker, I have to transport at least 14 to 18 players to travel. You have to feed them, you have to pay their allowances, you have to pay their monthly stipends. How many can afford to do that? Our only hope is that, Mr. Speaker, when you do spend and you are lucky for one major sale, you would have recovered your 10, 20 years lost investment in the area. But if you are unlucky, what happens to you? So, Minister, juvenile football and juvenile soccer across the country, then the pitches, Mr. Speaker, that's why I say, Mr. Speaker, one of my vocations at the weekend is to play football. Sometimes we come to the Accra Sports Stadium. It is not in good state. You easily can develop a knee injury. Just running and falling off a pothole with the boots can cause you a knee. And it's the state of it. Tamale, I help him, thanks to his generosity, in maintaining sometimes the Tamale Sports Stadium. even grassing and other issues are still a problem. So I'm sure in future you have to come back. The Upper East region and your own corner there will need a sports stadium in that area, in the Upper West region, in that area, in the Volta region, if you look at the stadium, not up to scratch. You have to plan ahead. But these are all matters Corporate Ghana should be able to work with you in order that they can build it and then lease it out. Mr. Speaker, tolerate me for taking too much time. Finally, in Ghana, and that one, Mr., I don't know how you want to work it. Branding. In the United Kingdom, they have branded football very well. So for them, when you are entering Downing Street 10, football is Great Britain. Innovation is Great Britain. Ghana. Every Ghanaian this weekend, Mr. Speaker, is interested in the Chelsea Man U scores. Not Mediami versus RTU versus House of Oak or versus Kotoko, Mr. Speaker. Growing up, we all enjoyed hearing Ukuma Pima Apimbeba. It is lost in our vocabulary. The pride with which we supported local football, particularly when you heard, where you now, and then secondly, Showboys. Where you now? Then, Honor Mutalenko, Mr. Speaker, at the time, he was poor like me, the wall. Honor Mutala. We used to scale the Canada Sports Stadium just to catch a glimpse of football because we couldn't afford to pay. So we go holding the walls of the bricks there to find or we plan that the gate man will go and push him, Mr. Speaker. But on my point, how come that today every Ghanaian at the weekend is interested in English Premier and then La Liga? And probably what goes on in France, but not interested in what goes in Ghana. So, Minister, you have a responsibility to rebrand football in Ghana and to make competitive football attractive to Ghanaians and to take advantage. Ghana has, Mr. Speaker, lots of talents in football. And, Mr. Speaker, the better we provide them opportunities today, there will be the Abedi Peles. There are some Wajans of tomorrow, but they need an opportunity. And the juvenile football, Mr. Speaker, as I've said, you only see us take it seriously when foreign scouts come into a region. Then we are told that get children who are between 14 to 17 to 16 to come and display. We have never heard it from government sources or GFA sources that we want to be able to undertake scouting, a competitive football to know our talents at that level. So, Mr. Speaker, once again, let me thank the Honorable Minister and to assure him that we will stand strong with you. So, what you say and what you do is what may divide the support behind you. So, keep the solidarity and the momentum high. We will support you to succeed. The Honorable Dr. Rashid Pepo has been there as Minister. The Honorable Muntaka has been there as Minister. They all, Ayanga was there. They have some modicum of success, but we are not there yet. The state of football development in Ghana today is abysmal, nothing more. It is nothing to be proud of, but you can make us proud by making sure that we take part in AFCON, not just participate, but to win our fifth trophy, and that we get represented in Qatar for the World Cup. So, Mr. Speaker, once again, let me thank you for the opportunity and assure the Minister that the country will stand firm and strong with you in supporting the Black Stars. And we expect Corporate Ghana to be generous with resources to support you as you do it. And as I said, you quietly can engage the Honorable Minister for Communication. Some of it is not, it's just that diplomacy. They will be able to find a way to assist you by way of sponsorship so that the Black Stars can make us proud. As for our history, it's one of 1960 and 1982. We want a history today. In the 2020s, this is how the Black Stars fed. I thank you, Mr. Speaker.